flinching in their support.
Big part of the picture.
All right, I think we are through this item unless anybody else has anything else. And we are, and I don't have any public comment on that one, so we're moving to the final item, which is E. And this is for the update on the protection of the Orange Hammock Ranch. Commissioner Caragiulo?
Oh, Carolyn Brown is going to do this one for us.
All right.
Great, good afternoon. For the record, Carolyn Brown, Director of Parks, Recreation, and Natural Resources, and I'm here to provide an update on Orange Hammock Ranch. As already mentioned, Tara Polton is here from Swift Mud and is in the audience, as well as John Robinson, Division Manager of Natural Area Parks and Preserves and Trails from our team. Before you is a map of Sarasota County, and located in pink is Orange Hammock. Here's a close-up. The 5,700-acre Orange Hammock Ranch is located in the eastern area of Sarasota County, northeast of I-75 and approximately 3 miles east of North Toledo Blade in the city of Northport. It is bordered by R.V. Griffin Reserve in DeSoto County on the east, Snover Canal to the south, private land on both the west and north sides. R.V. Griffin Reserve in DeSoto County is 6,000 acres of conservation lands, which is owned by Swift Mud and managed by the Peace River, Minnesota Regional Water Supply Authority. Snover Canal is a major source of drinking water and flood prevention. Longino Ranch is privately held to the north. Sarasota County and Swift Mud have acquired conservation easements over Longino Ranch. As you can see here, there is a very long history with this property. It was first identified in 1998 and was included in the county's Environmentally Sensitive Lands Protection Program's Eastern Ranch Land Protection Priority Site. The county made several attempts since 2004 to acquire this property because of its habitat and hydrological value and wildlife corridor connection and floodplain protection. In 2010, the county received a land nomination through the ESLPP program for Orange Hammock Ranch. In 2011, two appraisals were obtained. In May of 2013, Swift Mud attempted to purchase Orange Hammock Ranch. In June of 2014, the Conservation Foundation of the Gulf Coast submitted a Florida Forever project to the state. In March and April of 2016, the county and the Conservation Foundation obtained appraisals. And October of 2016, there was an option agreement made with the Conservation Foundation and the owners, but that expired at that time. In March and April of 2017, an offer was made and a counteroffer was submitted and received. The benefits of the property are to protect and enhance existing drinking water resources, provide flood protection to Northport. It enhances natural systems and regional connectivity of wildlife corridors, and there is the potential for recreational activities. More recently, on March 20th of 2017, Swift Mud sent an offer letter to purchase the property in the amount of $18 million on behalf of Sarasota County and Swift Mud. A letter was received from the owner's representative on April 3rd with a county counter offer of a cash purchase in the amount of $22 million. The county and Swift Mud are working to identify other funding sources. Swift Mud indicated they potentially have up to $9 million towards the conserving the property, and they've noted that their policy is to pay up to 90% of the appraised value. So as it stands right now, Sarasota County and Swift Mud have ordered revised appraisals, and we are waiting to hear back from those we have ordered those from. And once we do, the appraisals will be evaluated, and we will continue to seek opportunities and options to conserve this property.
Thank you. Yeah. Commissioner Mann.
Carolyn, if we could go back to that aerial, please. You can get that. There we go. I'm chairman of the Minnesota Peace River Regional Water Authority, and I represent, for the last 3 years, I've represented Sarasota County, and in so doing, the city of Northport. You get some of your water there. Just to be clear again, because I interacted with a lot of you all over the last 3 years, the Water Authority has commissioned an engineering firm, and they've finished their work, that a third reservoir, there's currently two on the RV Griffith Preserve, a third reservoir fits on RV Griffith. So there's no potential, no thought, no plan to put another reservoir on Orange Hammock. The next thing, we've commissioned engineering firms to go and update our water withdrawal permits, because we still allow an awful lot of water in the rainy season to just roar out to the bay and not capture it. Yeah. And also, there's a firm commitment from the Water Authority that the probable, very possible, actual potable surface water flow across that property will continue to go unimpeded down to the Snover Canal, which feeds into the city of Northport's water treatment plant. So I want to emphasize that again. I do very frequently at the authority meetings, just so folks know what the plans are. And I know that Pat Lehman is here also from the Water Authority.
All right, very good. Any other questions? Okay.
Thank you, Carolyn.
And on that aerial that you had up there, that little chunk or notch out at the end of the Walton Ranch, mm-hmm. is that little piece that was
right here? Are you referring to
the top, yeah. the aerial, the little top piece between Walton and Longino?
That one.
Yeah.
The southeast corner there.
That little, yeah. Is that where earlier it was being talked about as far as the looking into potential conservation easement or for the trail connectivity, the piece? Or is that further to the west?
Hi, John Robinson, Sarasota County Parks, Recreation, and Natural Resources. The on the Longino property, which is the property outlined in yellow,
yeah,
that's got a conservation easement on it, and it's also got a recreational trails easement on it. The property that we identified earlier is on the other side of Walton Ranch.
The western side of Walton Ranch.
And that portion also has a conservation easement with a recreational trails easement. We're just negotiating the fine points on that.
Okay. All right. All right, I have a public comment card. Thank you for the update and information. This is from Peter Bartolotta. Come on up.
Thank you, it's the fun side.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
My name is Peter Bartolotta, Northport resident. And, you know, when I first came to Florida in 1990, I went to a place called Boca Raton. Really nice, but wasn't very natural. You know, a lot of concrete. And I came out to visit my wife's aunt and uncle in Northport, and I fell in love with this area. I thought Florida was palm trees and Atlantic Ocean. I thought that's what it was. The West Coast is beautiful. And I think what the county has done with preserving large tracts of land is admirable, because it'll never become like the East Coast. And I think that's what we all tried to do when this started out. As you all know, Northport, when I moved here, it was 90 square miles. I think it's, 104 now? But it was all platted lots. So platted lots are really okay if you're a spot builder, but it doesn't leave much room to develop any sense of a community or shopping or industrial or job markets or any of that, because it's platted lots, quarter acre lots. I think to Northport's credit, back when they did it, I gave up on the years, I forget now, but they annexed West Villages and the Orange Hammock Ranch with the intent to improve our tax base. There were large tracts of land that could be developed and generate a tax base in addition to, so it's not being thrown on the local residents. What's going on in West Villages is a testament to what that can do. I got involved in the Orange Hammock back in 2011 and challenged it and was against it, because of that 5,700 acres, 2,000 of it is and the quote you'll hear out there is mine when I say it's drop-dead gorgeous. It really is, and it should be preserved. That's the orange hammock. Before that, it was the McCall Ranch, which had the orange hammock on it. Then they changed the name to the Orange Hammock Ranch, which is 5,700 acres, but the orange hammock is 2,000. Mm-hmm. So we're now taking taxpayers' money to take it, to annex it into the city, and now we're going to use taxpayers' money to take it out of the city, and with it, the tax base for potential for it. Norport has an opportunity, as you've been reading, for a hospital, and if I can quote Peter Lear, if the quote was right, Peter, the hospital wanted 30 acres, and he said, we have no land. Well, wouldn't it be cool if we could actually negotiate with the owners who are on the East Coast to, yeah, let's buy the land, but let's take a chunk of it. Let's take 500 acres or whatever and give it to the city of Norport that you could then use to negotiate and build on instead of taking the whole thing out of the bucket. So I would challenge the commissions today to come up with a solution that allows us to pursue that additional tax base that's available to us at the Orange Hammock Ranch, give access to Norport to the preservation goals, but let's expedite or expand the tax base in the process. So let's get creative. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Lear, did you have any clarification?
Well, it wasn't too far off. We don't have 30 acres of land, is what I said.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay. Anybody else have any comments on that? Just Vice Mayor? I know you're trying to refrain yourself.
I'm trying to behave.
You?
I really am.
We're proud.
I just have mixed feelings on Orange Hammock. I agree with Peter that there is a set amount of, as someone who is very intimately familiar with the property, there is a set amount of acreage that should be considered protected. But for the most part, I've been on that land. It's not areas that need protection. There's some portions within it that you could very well have a building on. And the thought of losing all that commercial base and that taxable value really concerns me as far as our comprehensive plan is concerned. However, in the same token, I do believe that there is a portion of it that should be conserved. I'm not arguing that fact. But I think, I mean, my long-term thought for this property would be a collaboration where we would have that property intermingle with the Griffin and be connected. But yet we would still allow some lower scale type of commercial development on it, being tiny homes, rental cabins, kayak rental, a natural garden, something that kind of leads into what it is that we're trying to sell, but we're not going to put a commercial business on there that's large scale and high volume. And I guess that what I'm looking for is just kind of that open dialogue that's a possibility.
If I may,
Commissioner Caruso.
As far as our board really has looked to the city of Norport to sort of be at the head of this, because it's your space. I of course understand that there was a substantive conversation and an action taken, mm-hmm. but you I think really have to kind of figure out what you would like us to do and help with and go forward with. There's an awful lot of folks out there who are very excited about preservation of the entire property. I am not a commercial real estate developer. I have no idea about what infrastructure, utilities, or all these other challenges, or what is quote-unquote developable and what isn't. But, I mean, I thought that we were all on the same page. If that is no longer the case, then you need to let us know.
Right.
Pretty quickly. Mm-hmm. I'm completely in support of preservation of the entire property, but I'm not going to get into a debate with your city and your constituents over what they'd like to see there. And I speak for myself, naturally.
I have a couple of questions. Going back to the annexation of this area to the far east, it was my understanding it was over 9,000 acres, the entirety of what was annexed at that time. 9,000 acres. Can anybody attest to that? And most of which has been, and I think has that future land use for commercial development.
Yeah, and I want to say it was 2000. And it was definitely 2000. After West Villages.
Yeah.
I was on the board for that.
I'm guilty of West Villages, but I don't think I'm guilty.
You're not making claim to that, yeah. To that one. Okay. So the entirety of it, because it goes all the way to Toledo Blade, I believe, mm-hmm. that whole... Yes. section was annexed Palmer? At that time. And, you know, as far as this orange hammock now, I believe it's nine parcels under one ownership. And I think one of the challenges when this conversation came up maybe 2 years ago was that the owner now of all of it renamed the whole thing Orange Hammock, but will not separate mm-hmm. ownership of those nine parcels. It's all or not.
Nothing.
And so I just wanted to just share that's kind of what we were mm-hmm. faced with.
I think that's mm-hmm. that's my understanding. Okay. And, you know, we have people challenge us about the county's purchases of a lot of other land, but what they have to understand is the ranchers mm-hmm. are not, you buy it all, I don't want a remnant right. piece, or right. buy nothing.
Right. So. Because they're looking, while they don't want to be the caretakers anymore of that, they have an interest to keep and preserve and conserve those areas.
If you look at the aerial, just kind of a historical, it's the Curry Ranch that was annexed, and it was essentially those areas that are outside of Orange Hammock, both to the north and the east. That's where that 9,000 acres came from. Yeah, but regardless, I think that we do need a direction. We do need to know, but I really would like to, well.
You know, absent.
I don't know.
This
nor here current, nor there if we don't have the money.
Absent
for
the current Northport yeah, City North Commission State. Currently, because there's been a change, obviously, with the commission. Mm-hmm. I think that, and we're not going to accomplish that today, but I think if there's, you know, conversation to be had as far as this commission currently goes in possibly having a conversation, is there a different direction or so on? I think that would be something that we would have to put on our agenda, have that conversation, yeah, I mean, I'm get always... back to the county commission to keep them updated. But as far as now, you know, it's nine parcels all stuck together. They're moving yeah. forward with what they're doing. And
yeah, honestly, it was just not something I expected to hear today, so I really yeah. don't know quite how to react.
Yeah, no, I realize that, and I was just trying to, you know, just like with the addressing of Ortiz, that's something the county has to take to their agenda. Mm-hmm. So glad you're doing that, Commissioner Hines. And so
we're going to rename River Road Ortiz yeah. and then change
oh,
other.
There we go.
Yeah, there we go.
I like it.
Yeah. So I mean, if that, I would just say to my commission that, you know, if we need to have that conversation. Then, you know, thanks. Vice Mayor, that might be something that.
Please let us know how you would like to proceed.
Yes.
Yes.
So, is that fair enough?
Certainly.
Okay. All right. And just in the essence of time, trying to keep this going before 5 to conclude. Go ahead.
Do we have a timeline that we are having?
6 o'clock today.
No. For the orange hammock, because
6 o'clock today.
6 o'clock today.
No, I don't. I mean, I'm. You know,
because it looks like you've got things in the works, and that's why.
Yeah,
that's
yeah,
why I'm wondering
we've
got
things
if
in
you
works. Absolutely, that would be an understatement.
An answer like sooner than later. Then we need to direct staff to put this on the agenda sooner than later, and that's kind of where I was going with what is your. What are your constraints and timelines and.
My constraint is the initial shock of perhaps going. No, to be really honest with you, I mean,
I haven't had this conversation.
That was the last thing that I expected to hear today, and it's not a judgment. It's not. I'm just saying, wow. That's.
I'm with you. I'm kind of shocked to myself.
I've said it for months.
Yeah.
I've said it for months,
Commissioner May.
Nobody listens to me.
Let me say a few things here. First of all, I've been probably the prime mover and motivator of this. And I have my longtime friend smiling at me the entire time of her delivery. And I'm always decent when I want to push back on Commissioner Carusone, because she knows far too much about me for the last 25 years. This is something we painstakingly took through a process. Mm-hmm. It was brought up before a previous Northport City mm-hmm. Commission. That has changed. And I'm in a little bit of the same mode as Commissioner Caragiulo about being a bit surprised. These negotiations are going forward, and everybody is pushing them to a solid conclusion. Hopefully at less than the asking price of $22 million, and I want to be very careful here because these are not things you negotiate in front of a TV
right.
camera.
Mm-hmm.
But we're roaring ahead, and I also would say that this is the big, wide piece that goes from the Myakka River to the Peace River. That's one of the reasons, in addition to many others, that this piece fits in to this corridor. And I mean, really, that's all I wanted to say about this. But I know it was the elephant in our little mm-hmm. set of tables here.
You know, and I can express to you that, you know, being the one that was on the previous board as well, I had some concerns initially, looked into things, and also looked at the sensitivities of this area. And, you know, I think there's positive opportunity as far as the passive recreational opportunities that do exist, which maybe is not commercial, but when you talk tax base and you talk about just benefit to Northport, there's mm-hmm. a lot of benefit there. And I really am still of the position that I was previously in moving forward as things need to move forward. So, and each of our commissioners can share, but it doesn't mean that we couldn't have our own conversation, understanding that things are going forward and moving in that direction that they need to. So I don't know if any other commissioners want to.
Is anybody on the board? I would just say very quickly that, I mean, if you're talking about a source of funds, this is a very, it's my understanding there are very regimented rules as to what right. environmentally sensitive lands can be used. I don't know that there's even a device to acquire if the owner is unwilling to split it up.
Exactly.
I mean, I don't know what do you say?
Yeah,
because
exactly.
you're not using environment, and I don't think Swift Mud's going to be okay with
right.
with any of that either. I mean, this is a big deal, and hopefully you guys can let us know what y'all want to do.
Well, that's why I wanted to share kind of where I'm at. I don't want to certainly take any opportunity from any commissioner.
People are rowing now. So.
And maybe it would be helpful if the other commissioners would share as well. Yeah.
I think that there's several things that give me heartburn about this project. But then I also see that there are several things that there are opportunities on this direction that was taken in the past. And so I think that I'm just going to let this lay until we as a commission have our discussion, and then we can give direction to the county as to our position. That's where I'm at.
Madam Chair.
Yes.
If I could just take 1 minute on this, I'll be quick. I know it's late in the day, but I've had a very unique perspective on this because I was on the governing board of Swift Mud throughout much of this process, and now I sit in this seat. And I can tell you, Commissioner Caragiulo, you said this perfectly and summed it up perfectly, is it is necessary for a clear vision on this. And if you ask me, very wrapped around ecotourism, economic stimulus, and other matters, because at Swift Mud, the visions were crystal clear of why we get involved in these things, crystal clear. And when we deal with our partners in this, we expect a crystal clear vision that's in tune with what we're doing. So I just have some genuine concern. The humongous cherry on the top of this is, personally, I'm a little fatigued over negotiating with ourselves over this property for years. We're literally negotiating with ourselves. Is that we're coming down to the end of a process where we're close, in a reasonable discussion close of having a true 50-50 match in this. But again, we're negotiating on the other side that doesn't feel the same way. So I think a very short-term, absolutely necessary step is a clear vision of what you guys want on this and how we can help. Mm-hmm. You summarized it perfectly, Commissioner Caragiulo. That's all I have.
Commissioner McDowell, did you have something? No? Commissioner Luke?
Yeah, I was involved in some of the discussions that went on a couple years ago when the letters and that were sent, and I'm still viewing it the same way that you are, Mayor, that it's nine entities that say, you know, go. So I don't mind talking, but to me, we move forward with what we have.
Mm-hmm. Commissioner McDowell?
It's my understanding that the prior commission had it so that it was going to be 100% conserved. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And the city of Northport was not a party to this. This is privately owned, and it's being pursued by the county and Swift Mud. And
well, it was, though. It sent a letter of support.
Right.
So that's what can't say so that it wasn't a party.
The city did send a letter of support similar to what the county sent to the foundation, Conservation Foundation.
I'm talking about a purchasing partner.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay.
Oh. There's something going on. Even all over. Yeah. But as far as any changes, in my opinion, no, I'm all for keeping it conserved. But I guess that'll have to be another conversation for later.
Sooner rather than later, I would like to say. Yeah.
Maybe we can get that on our July meeting. Or have a special meeting. That's probably a special meeting issue. I don't know.
Yeah, we can, you know, certainly do that. Like I said, we've heard from three commissioners here, and probably would take a whole heck of a lot for me to change my position on this, I think, as far as we've come and where we're at. So, Commissioner,
I do have another topic. I was at EMU this past weekend and heard that Sarasota County withdrew from the Southwest Regional Planning Council.
Yes.
Could I get a little information on
that,
please?
Your guy right there. Commissioner Hines.
Commissioner Hines.
And I'm also the representative for the city of Northport for that.
Good. We're just trying to save you some time. No. this is, yeah, and money. Well, we pay for the cities right now, and we have.
Saving ourselves money.
So, you know, over the last several years, the role of the Regional Planning Council has been diminished.